If you haven't heard of Arduino, it's an entire ecosystem created for playing with and working with microcontrollers. There are many boards available that are considered to be Arduino compatible. There's also software you can download, which is the Arduino development environment, that you can use to program the different boards. Almost everything in the Arduino world is considered to be open source. That means I can go online and find the schematics for these different boards, and I can go and get the source code for the development environment. One of the other cool things about Arduino is its ability to stack with these things called shields. For example, we have this MP3 player shield that we can stack on top of a few different Arduinos. This allows us to play music and other sound files. SparkFun offers many different Arduino-compatible boards that you can program with the Arduino software. First up, we have Arduino's flagship and most popular board, the Uno. The Arduino Uno is built around the Atmel Atmega 328P microcontroller. This runs at 16 megahertz. It offers 14 digital input-output pins, or I/O pins, and 6 of those can be used for pulse width modulation, or PWM. On the other side, you'll notice another 6 pins that can be used for analog inputs. The 328P offers 32 kilobytes of flash memory, which is used for holding programs, and 2 kilobytes of RAM. Notice that the input-output pins run at 5 volts, which means you want to be careful if you're trying to connect it to 3.3-volt logic. You could easily damage something. There are two versions of the Uno available. First is the plated through-hole version, or PTH. You can remove the microcontroller if you really want, just be careful doing it. And then there's the SMD, or surface mount version. This uses a lower profile version of the microcontroller, but offers the same functionality as the PTH version. The Uno is a great board if you're just getting started in the world of Arduino or embedded electronics. There's tons of documentation online you can find about it. Next, we have the SparkFun Red board. This is SparkFun's version of the Arduino with similar functionality to the Uno. It combines several of our favorite features from different Arduinos into one board. It is a bit cheaper, and it allows us to control revisions and features when we teach classes with Arduino. Then we have the Arduino Pro. This uses the same 328P microcontroller, so it has more or less the same functionality as the Uno. The biggest difference you'll notice is that the Pro comes without headers. This gives the user the option to solder on wires, male or female headers, whatever they want. There are two different versions of the Pro, the 3.3 volt version and the 5 volt version. You'll notice that some electronics can only handle 3.3 volts. You could easily damage these sensitive electronics with something like 5 volts. Notice that the speed has been reduced to 8 megahertz for the 3.3 volt version, but the 5 volt version still has a whopping 16 megahertz. The Arduino Pro does not have built-in USB support, so you're going to need a serial cable or an FTDI breakout to program them. Make sure that the voltage of the cable or the breakout matches the voltage listed on your Arduino Pro, otherwise you could end up hurting some electronics. If you thought the Pro was cool, check out the Pro Mini. It's exactly like the Pro, but in a tiny form factor. Like the Pro Mini comes in 3.3 and 5 volt versions, and you will need a serial cable or FTDI breakout to program them. The Pro Mini is my favorite Arduino board to prototype with. It's small, it's cheap, and it's easy to fit on a breadboard. Because there's a 3.3 volt version available, it's great to use with 3.3 volt sensors. Then, we have the Pro Micro. This is similar to the Pro Mini, but you don't need a special serial cable or FTDI breakout to program it. The first thing you'll notice about the Pro Micro is that there's a micro USB port on the board. It also uses a different chip. It uses the Atmega 32U4, which has built-in USB support. There are 12 digital I/O pins, and 5 of those can be used for PWM. There's an additional 4 analog input pins on the board as well. Like the 328P, the chip contains 32 kilobytes of flash, but there's a bit more RAM at 2.5 kilobytes. Like the Pro Mini, the Pro Micro comes in 3.3 volt and 5 volt versions, where the 3.3 volt version runs at 8 megahertz and the 5 volt version runs at 16 megahertz. One cool feature about the Pro Micro is that it can be used as a USB device. For example, I made this simple USB joystick that I can use to control the mouse around my screen. Next, we have the MicroView. This is a small Arduino-compatible module with a built-in OLED display. The OLED display is monochrome with a 64 by 48 pixel resolution. The MicroView uses the same Atmega 328P microcontroller found in many of the other Arduino products. There's 12 digital I/O pins and 6 analog input pins. Notice that the pins run at 3.3 volt logic. There are a few ways to program the MicroView, although the best is to use the MicroView programmer. This is a really cool device to use if you just want to make some simple graphics. And then, there's the Arduino Mega 2560. This is an Uno on steroids. The Mega uses the Atmega 2560 processor running at 16 megahertz. There's a whopping 54 digital I/O pins, and 15 of those can be used for PWM. There's an additional 16 analog inputs as well. It has 256 kilobytes of flash, which is a lot of room for your programs, and 8 kilobytes of RAM. This is a great device for when you need a ton of pins. It also has 4 hardware serial ports, where the Uno only has one. I find it really useful for when you're connecting to other serial peripherals and you need to send debugging information back to your computer. This is the Teensy 3.1, made by Paul and Robin at pjrc.com. The Teensy can be programmed with the Arduino software, but it's built around the Freescale MK20DX256. This is a 32-bit ARM Cortex-M4 processor running at 72 megahertz. This is 4 times faster than the Uno. It has 256 kilobytes of flash, 64 kilobytes of RAM, and 34 I/O pins. All of these can be digital I/O pins, 12 of them can be PWM, and 21 can be used for analog input. This thing has some serious processing power, and it's great for projects where you want that kind of power or you need that number of pins, but you don't want to go to a full operating system like Linux running on a single board computer. It's powerful enough, for example, to run our 32x32 LED panel. Finally, we have the Arduino Uno, and this is closer to a single board computer. The Arduino Uno has 2 processors on board. Underneath the metal can is an Atheros AR9331, which is typically found in Wi-Fi routers. It works at 400 MHz and runs a custom version of Linux known as OpenWRT Uno. Additionally, there's an Atmega 32U4 on board, which can be programmed with Arduino. It has 32 kilobytes of flash and 2.5 kilobytes of RAM, much like the Pro Micro. There's some features on the Uno not found on other Arduino boards. For example, it has Ethernet and Wi-Fi already on board, and it can work as a USB host, so you can do things like plug in a flash drive. There's a micro USB port for programming, power, and communications, and a micro SD card slot on the back side. There's 20 I/O pins, of which 7 of those can be used for PWM and 12 for analog input. You can program Linux directly using a command line over serial through the 32U4 or logging in with something like SSH. You can write Python programs in Linux, as OpenWRT Uno comes preloaded with Python 2.7. The Uno is a great way to network your electronics projects and get started with the Internet of Things. There are definitely more Arduino-compatible boards than what I've shown you here, but I hope I've given you some idea about what's available in the world of Arduino. It's a great place to start if you've never played with microcontrollers or you just want to prototype some electronics quickly. Check out learn.sparkfun.com to see some cool projects and learn more about Arduino.